Oh, okay.
Wow. That was live.
Okay, are we on?
Yes, we're live.
All right, awesome. What's up, guys? Sorry to get you. At number something. SUGA versus ShiNe happening right now. SUGA pulling out his never-before-seen Pikachu, which is very interesting so far. I'm not going to count him out yet, but he is in the process of getting three stock.
Yeah.
But, sometimes...
The reason for SUGA's pick here for Pikachu, for those of you guys wondering, is that he's actually been practicing a secondary for a little while, so he's been looking for something. But the funny thing I tell people is that Yoshi mains are so dedicated. I've never heard of a Yoshi main with a secondary.
Yeah, no, me too.
I've never heard of such a thing.
I was thinking about it, like... Yeah, no, I can't think of a single one almost. And as I was like, saying, you know, sometimes like people are like, oh, this Pikachu, you know, why is he playing Pikachu? He's getting three stock. This is how you learn a secondary,
yeah.
Even a co-main. Like this is gonna happen. Like this is gonna happen when you're picking up a new character. Like, you know, sometimes when stuff like that happens, that forward smash, I try to give it credit. Like, oh, look at nice read, nice this. But that was like actually just.
Nah, bro, it was mashing.
That was like an actual. I really hope this hits, and it hit, and good stuff to SUGA. Okay.
Oh yeah. That's going to hit under.
Well, ShiNe taking that first game in quarters with Pokemon Trainer. I believe ShiNe is going all Trainer today.
Do you know what I get mad about? I'm so sorry. Totally
go
irrelevant. I get mad about that some characters actually have good costumes. Like why is Alf a secondary? I know this is going to really appeal to you here. Why is Alf a secondary for Olimar? And why can't, like, Bayonetta have alternate costume as... You know what what I'm saying? Like, so sometimes it just doesn't make any sense.
I like how Daisy and Peach are separated, but Alfred and Olimar are the same character, even though it's the same thing. It's the same thing.
Yes.
It's pretty much the same thing, except, you know, Daisy has different, like, sound effects on her back hair, I guess.
She actually doesn't say the Peach Bomber.
So, yeah,
when,
like,
yeah.
She goes, like, yeah, after she moves.
Yeah.
Instead of Peach going, like, Hot Shaw or whatever the hell she says. And getting into the second game, we got SUGA switching to his tried and true Yoshi versus ShiNe's, once again, trainer on Stadium as well. This stage is very good for Yoshi, according to SUGA. From what I've talked to him and from what I've seen, he's really good at converting off the platforms with his up tilt and up air conversions. And ShiNe, you know, he's a fan of the stage as well. No reason to ban it really in this matchup.
Unless you're actually fighting Snake. That's actually one stage you don't want to fight
right,
Snake.
Right, of course.
That's what I always tell people. Like, sometimes I try to be careful where the snake mains are at, because if you actually do give them the stage, you're going to be in for a quick.
Even then, it just depends on the character. Like, Mario on this stage versus Snake is going to like it.
Wolf
for sure. Is going to be fine on this stage. It just depends on the stage list as well. Like, because there's better stages for sure. And pretty much even game right now. ShiNe does have him off stage. How's he going to is he going to convert this into a stock?
Oh, he tried to go for a high recovery there, but ShiNe had the up smash.
Right, he caught his landing on top. That's a lot of Yoshis. You know, they love to use their aerial drift to either drift past you or land on top of you. It's very tempting to do with Yoshi.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's something you really pretty much always expect if you're fighting a Yoshi and they're drifting in the air. And ShiNe getting that back air off the air dodge, and that wasn't the best DI coming out from SUGA. Either no DI or bad DI cost him that stock.
The one thing, too, about Yoshi as well is, like, we love to cross up, too, especially with Nair, a couple of those moves. So you kind of have to really respect Yoshi the minute he crosses you up and then wait to see his reaction. Like, see, he crosses up there, and he wanted to see how ShiNe was going to go for it, so he goes for a back air instead. And Yoshi's tail moves are all disjointed, too. That's one thing to definitely...
ShiNe is dominating this game right now with Zard. This is a very scary position to be in. At the ledge versus Zard, with his tail spaced away from you, is very difficult. His back air will kill you with this percent. His F-tilt will also, at the ledge, kill you. Got hit by that reversal Nair, but isn't able to... Didn't secure the stock.
Oh, there it is.
Good reaction from SUGA. Reacted to the air dodge onto the stage. ShiNe really didn't have anywhere to go after that. He could have, I guess, Flare Bliss for another mix-up. He could have, like, attacked, or he could have gone to ledge, but he had no ledge invincibility, so, you know, SUGA was just prepared for it.
That's my dodge. I like the fact that ShiNe is kind of really respectful here at the ledge, because he doesn't want to, like, go for a read or go something too overzealous, because, you know, if you give Yoshi the ledge, you're giving Yoshi quite a lot.
Right. Landed on him with that safe up air.
Oh, nice. Pops out of the egg just enough time to actually get away. This is a solid Yoshi combo. Couple up airs. Puts him at 59%. If I were SUGA right here, the pressure at the ledge, I'm telling you, if you give Yoshi the ledge, he's definitely going to have a lot to work with.
ShiNe able to get back the center stage easily, and now the roles have been reversed. Ooh. SUGA stuck at the ledge.
Ooh. I'm really curious, too. It's probably because of the end lag and, like, Yoshi as well. Like, we don't see Charizard go for Flamethrower at all.
Right, it just depends on the case. So,
yeah.
Flamethrower is better versus recoveries like Wolves or Foxes, where you'll flamethrower them to set up for a down air.
Yeah.
So they don't immediately grab ledge.
Oh, Yoshi, that's right. And then Yoshi has double jump armor.
Right. Yoshi has double jump armor, and he doesn't really go for ledge like that often when he's recovering, unless it's like an egg or Like, he has something to cover it pretty much every time. ShiNe might as well throw out a big hitbox there instead of just a neutral B.
Oh, what a good parry. Sets himself up for that back air. If you sweet spot it, you will die.
This is looking very good for ShiNe right now. Let's see if Suga's able to get off the ledge and bring this back. Suga's been at the ledge for a solid 30 seconds, I think. That should be a little bit slow on the reaction
there. Oh, no. Even with the parry, too, you need to parry the other hits from back air.
Right.
Back air has multiple hits. So you have to parry each one in order to react.
Sort of had that game. He reacted a little bit slow with the up smash. Mm-hmm. Parry the first hit of Yoshi's back air. Maybe thought he could hit him in between the hits. There's some moves that can do that. Hit in between multi-hits. But ShiNe just wasn't able to get it. And Suga right now is in a... Oh, that was unlucky. He fell out of it.
Oh, that was solidly spaced back air. But unfortunately, like, he was kind of... close to that range where Suga is able to get the grab. Oh, like that. Using the FD hop to try to mix up the timing with back air. ShiNe is losing so much momentum here just for trying to get this one stock. Even though Charizard is the play in terms of weight and damage, I feel like this is a little too much to pay for.
Wow, that didn't kill.
No switch up. I like that. Using those jumps and what a reversal.
Suga committed a little bit too much there going off the stage.
Yeah.
I feel like he was at the percent where it was better for him to hold his ground. Instead of trying to commit to an edge guard when Charizard had his jump, like his two jumps and his, he had all his resources. It was a little bit early to go off stage there, and he paid for it.
Yeah, it was definitely a little too early. The one thing I did like is how ShiNe kind of came back on the stage, right? Reversed the rules. Charizard at that point though was pretty scary to have on deck. Yeah, like that was like almost a really scary like pick to stay on. We are seeing Jump Steady versus Leaf FC.
Oh, that's Leaf. I was like, who is that?
Yeah. I think, if I'm not mistaken, if you don't want to really count the PR in that sense, like, Nico is probably, funny enough, the best Falcon in SoCal. But
yeah,
if we're talking about solo Falcon,